Elastoplastic and fracture behavior of semicrystalline polymers under multiaxial stress states. Introduction. The deformation behavior and fracture mechanisms of high-density polyethylene, polypropylene, and polyimide 6 are investigated experimentally under different stress states and at different cross-hatch speeds of 120 and 200 millimeters per minute. Test results on cylindrical notch specimens reveals that at higher crosshatch speeds increased both the propensity of the materials to form a clear and higher yield load. The yield load increased with increasing the specimen notch, really increasing the stress triaxiality. From the experimental test on combined tensile shear, one can conclude that drop of the load with the biaxial loading angle attains the maximum value for the loading angle at pure shear and maximum for pure tension. Fracture surface morphologies on cylindrical notch specimens reveals that the triaxiality influences the fracture morphology. At lower triaxiality, uniform fibrillar structure over the cross section is visible. The microstructure deformation mechanisms of butterfly specimens when loaded in combined loading angles at room temperature and temperature of 50 degrees Celsius show different modes of deformation. Mechanisms such as crazing voids and cavitation formation are being observed. It is observed that with increase in temperature, fracture becomes more homogeneous. Conclusions. Triaxiality, crosshatch speed, loading angles, and temperature influence the load displacement curves as well as the fracture morphology and determine whether the material behaves as brittle or ductile. The fracture surface analyzed reveals damage mechanisms such as crazing, void, and cavitation formation. Two or more mechanisms are predominant, which means that the stress along the fracture process are not uniform.